On Monday, Queen Elizabeth II sent a message of condolence to Haitian Prime Minister Ariel Henry amid the tragic aftermath of a recent earthquake that has ravaged the country. The Queen has shared her sadness at the devastation caused by the Haiti earthquake in a message of condolence to the Prime Minister of the Caribbean nation. The death toll from the 7.2 magnitude quake has risen to 1,297 as rescuers race to find survivors amid the rubble ahead of a potential deluge from an approaching tropical storm. Saturday's earthquake left around 5,700 people injured, with thousands displaced from their destroyed or damaged homes. The Queen's message to Haiti's Premier Ariel Henry read, "I am deeply saddened by the tragic loss of life and destruction caused by the earthquake in Haiti. I am deeply saddened by the tragic loss of life and destruction caused by the earthquake in Haiti," the Queen said in the statement. "My thoughts and prayers are with those who have lost their lives, loved ones and homes, as well as the emergency services working in the recovery effort. My thoughts and prayers are with those who have lost their lives, loved ones and homes, as well as the emergency services working in the recovery effort." As of Monday, the 7.2 magnitude quake has killed at least 1,297 people and caused untold damage, with anticipated tropical storms threatening to worsen the humanitarian crisis. Her Majesty is currently staying in Balmoral over the summer and is expected to return to Windsor Castle in October. The Queen has been joined at Balmoral Castle over the summer by the Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall, the Duke of York and Sarah Ferguson. There are now concerns the rain from Tropical Depression Grace, which is due to hit Haiti on Monday and Tuesday, could cause landslides in the worst affected areas. Mr. Henry declared a state of emergency after the earthquake and mobilized resources to help victims. Hospitals across the country have been pushed to the brink and roads carrying critical supplies remain blocked. Mr. Henry said, "When it comes to medical needs, this is our biggest urgency. We have started to send medications and medical personnel to the facilities that are affected. For the people who need urgent special care, we have evacuated a certain number of them, and we will evacuate some more today and tomorrow. The devastation could worsen with the coming of Tropical Depression Grace, which is predicted to reach Haiti on Monday night and could bring heavy rain, flooding and landslides." The earthquake struck the southwestern part of the Western Hemisphere's poorest nation, almost razing some towns and triggering landslides that hampered rescue efforts in a country already struggling with the coronavirus pandemic, a presidential assassination and a wave of gang violence. This is not the first time Haiti has been devastated by an earthquake. In 2010, almost a quarter of a million lives were lost and 300,000 people were injured in a huge 7.0 magnitude earthquake. The 2010 quake resulted in about 1.5 million individuals living in displaced camps,